Still butt you up.
It's recording.
Yeah, please.
When me and Matt growing up, we got along very well. I mean, when I was three and I think Matt was six, we moved to the Philippines. We lived out there for 3 years. Matt's modelling career started off. And then we come back to England. We lived in Denby to start with. Went to St. Peter's School, grow up, both going to the same school, same secondary school. We've done the same college course now at college, and I don't see Matt as much as I used to, obviously because he's working now and he lives in London, and it's a bit hard to travel, but yeah, it's been good.
And I remember like being on the Isle of Wight with my older brother saying, you know, what do you want to do after school? And I wasn't sure, and I was saying, I wanted to be a policeman, a lawyer, well, clearly that's a bad idea, I've got 4 GCSEs, so being a lawyer is probably not the best idea. I think looking back on what I had done already, I think being in TV seemed like a kind of good idea. Well, it seemed like a thing I could do. We could try, but obviously it's not the easiest thing to get into. It looked like a challenge, but I wanted to take up and thought, why not? Why not pursue it and give it a go? When making a music video, it's never the easiest kind of thing to do. It's massively stressful. There's a lot of waiting around and relying on other people. You know, when you get given I speak to a label and I go, look, I like, you know, and we will send in briefs and pictures and storyboards and ideas of the song. Sometimes in your head, you might have a really great idea. It might be crazy, it might be really freaky. You might have animals running around in suits. You might want people having, you might want to have a bunch of bears fighting over a game of chess. People aren't going to understand that till they see it. It's so hard because not everyone's going to be happy, and making music videos is a compromise, and it is, you know, you have to work with your clients, the label's got to be happy, the band's got to be happy, and the people you work with have to be happy that they're going to work for you in circumstances or in these ideas. Oh, it was so hard. I mean, you can see in that newspaper story where it talks about I was out of contract working at Bloomberg and not having a job for a good 3 months. And I think that was a blessing in disguise, because it was so hard to kind of pick yourself up back up from that, especially in in January, February, March. It's a seasonal thing in TV where there's hardly any jobs going. You know, there's nothing no massive productions, there's no big entertainment shows. Christmas has just happened, so any Christmas specials, everyone's just having a bit of downtime. That is effectively the TV industry holiday time. To pick myself back up from that was doing these music videos. Because I was quite irritating as a student, chat around and mess around a lot, mess around with my friends, Matt and Sam, who were in my class. And because it's such a small class as well, it's easy to kind of try and make yourself stand out and be the kind of class clown.
Matt said when he was at college, he was a bit of a joker himself, and I feel that I'm kind of heading that direction, but I don't really want to follow Matt's footsteps completely, because I kind of want to write my own history as well. I want to do my own things, make my own videos. But I mean, that shows in my work, because my work's not going to be exactly the same as his. We have two different minds.
It's part of my life, and I don't think it makes me forget anyone, because I get everyone involved. I get all my friends on board to join in, and people ask me non-stop, oh, I want to work on this, I want to work with you, can you do this, can you Yeah, come on board. So people want to be a part of it.
And he's building himself up and he's keep going higher and higher and higher, and it's like the sky's the limit at the moment.
I'm building my own empire.